Good evening and welcome to the 60th commencement exercises of Hillel Torah North Suburban Day School. Mazal tov to all our graduates and families who came here to celebrate. The entire graduation, as you can tell, is being professionally videotaped and photographed so that everyone will be able to receive a copy of the video after and photographs as well. Takes a little bit of the pressure off. Please join me now, before our graduates, we're going to show our appreciation to our incredible and dedicated staff and faculty, as well as if there are members of board of directors as well who are with us tonight, as they march in ahead of our graduates. Let's get ready to greet our graduates. Thank you. Please rise for the singing of our national anthem. Be seated. Welcome to all the parents, grandparents. I even met some great grandparents who are here this evening. What a zchut. The faculty, staff, board members, communal leaders, family, and friends joining us this evening for this momentous occasion, the graduation, the class of 2024, Tavshin Pei Dalet. Thank you to the Jewish Federation of Metropolitan Chicago, the ATT, for their ongoing support and partnership, as well as to the Fairview School for the generous use of their auditorium this evening. Every week I remind the students in school before Shabbos to thank their teachers for a wonderful week of learning. They all know that by heart. There are many people who deserve to be thanked tonight for many wonderful years of learning. The Hillel Torah administration, our incredible team of teachers, office staff, security, the maintenance crews, every member of the school staff who nurtured your growth and took care of you over so many years. To the members of the board and the PTA, both now and past, whose unwavering support of our teachers and staff ensures that our school continues to grow and stay strong. Thank you for all your efforts. To our generous donors, our Society of Patrons, and others who have helped enable us to provide you with a top-tier education. And finally, acharon acharon chaviv, to your parents and grandparents who have invested so much in you and provided you with everything you needed, showing up to all of your school programs, even if they weren't always at the most convenient time, making your lunches, driving all your carpools, and really being your biggest cheerleaders. Thank you to all of the parents for everything you've done. Tonight, you will have a chance to hear from a number of our graduates who will speak on behalf of their classmates, sharing Divrei Torah and reflections on their years at Hillel Torah. To start us off, please give your attention to Sophie Levin, who will lead us in an opening Tehillah.
Welcome, rabbis, morot, teachers, administrators, family members, and guests. While we are thrilled to be graduating tonight, we are also thinking about our Jewish family in Israel. The events of October 7th deeply affected us as eighth graders and gave us unique opportunities to connect with Israel and Jews everywhere. At school, we've had assemblies, cookie sales, mishloach manot for the IDF, guest speakers who experienced October 7th firsthand, and extra learning in Tehillim. Through these activities, Hillel Torah has taught us to focus on the good and how we can make a difference even in dark times. This lesson of focusing on the positive and making a difference has been a constant theme throughout our time at Hillel Torah. It's reflected in Perek Kuf Chaf Aleph. Esa Einai El Harim Ein Yavo Ezri. I turn my eyes to the mountains, from where will my help come? We are always looking up, seeking ways to grow. This has been true in all areas of our school life. Whether we struggled in the class or faced social challenges, our teachers and advisors were always there to help us overcome them. from learning the ABCs to writing full essays, from addition to Y equals MX plus B, from our Kabbalat Sidur to leading davening, from our Chumash play to studying Rashi and preparing a Gemara Chabura. Our journey has had ups and downs. Through it all, our teachers in Rebbeim have taught us to stay positive and focus on the good. V'heyu einecha ra'ot et morecha. This means that we need to focus on what our teachers have taught us and the lessons we have learned from them. 9 years ago, we were little kids walking into the big new school building, afraid of getting lost. Now, as we move on to high school, we carry with us the lessons we've learned, the friendships we've made, and the memories we've created. Achshav kishanachnu avrim letichon, anachnu nosim itanu et hashirim shalamanu, et hamisarim shalamanu, et hachavarot sheyatzrenu, ve'et hazichronot sheyatzrenu. As we step into this new chapter, we will embrace the challenges and successes, continuing to learn and grow. Though we are leaving this familiar space behind, the friendships and lessons we've learned here will guide us through the challenging years ahead. Thanks to Hillel Torah, we are ready to focus on the positive and strive to grow as individuals, as B'nai and B'not Torah, and as ambassadors to the world.
Yasher Koach, Sophie, that was so beautiful. Dear graduates, Talmidim Yikarim, Zeh Hayom Asa Hashem Nagila V'Nismecha Bo. This moment, we take a pause to thank Hashem for this incredible milestone and bringing us to this day. And it didn't just happen by itself. You worked hard to get here, and you have so much to be proud of. Next week, we will be celebrating Chag Shavuot. In our davening, we refer to Shavuot as Zman Matan Torateinu, the holiday, the time of the giving of the Torah. However, in Perkei Avot, which we've been saying these past weeks, the first Mishnah famously says, Moshe Kibel Torah Misinai. Moshe received the Torah at Sinai. On the surface, it may seem these two phrases are identical, giving, receiving. In the end, it's a transaction. But if we look closely, they're in fact very different. The Gemara in Kiddushin Daf Lamed Bet discusses whether a Rav can be mochel on their honor, on their kavod. Can a Rav forego their honor? Rav Chista says no, because after all, the honor of the Rav, of the rabbi, is essentially the honor of the Torah. And what right does the rabbi have to be mochel on the honor of the Torah? It's not his. Rav Yosef, however, says yes. But isn't it the honor of the Torah? Not his? Rava comes to the rescue and explains that that may be true before someone learns Torah. But after one has learned Torah, once one has learned it, they make a kinyan, they acquire it, and it actually becomes theirs. And therefore, if something is yours, you can forgo it if you wish. The Gemara uses the phrase, Rava says, Torah dilehi. The Torah becomes belonging to that person. So Hashem may have given us the Torah on Shavuot, but the question is, did we receive it? Did we willingly and actively accept it and make it our own? That's the work we all need to do. Dear students, class of 2024, we've been through a lot over these past 11 years. And let's be honest, there are many times where you've kept us on our toes. You've tested some of your teacher's patience, maybe, challenged us and challenged each other, and at the same time made us laugh more times than we could count. You are a very special group of young men and women. You're a diverse group. You have a unique energy and a spirit, tremendous spirit, a lot of ruach, and a lot of personality. Baruch Hashem. You speak your mind, and you're searching appropriately for your identity and for relevance. And with all of this, we've seen you grow so much. Academically, as we just heard from Sophie, you've grown as readers, as writers, as Torah scholars, as Hebrew speakers, mathematicians, historians, artists, scientists, and more. And even more importantly, you've shown so much growth in who you are as people. The warmth and the care you show when you work with younger students, as you did recently with science at the carnival, the dedication you show as every day, breakfast and learn, making your own Maariv Minyan in the evenings before and after basketball games, the maturity that you showed as you took on the challenge of names, not numbers, the creativity and the fun that you displayed running the Purim Carnival this year and the bonding that you had on just a couple of weeks ago on the Washington trip. You've shown tremendous identification with our brothers and our sisters in Israel this year, davening every day for the release of our hostages, the safety of our chayalim, and refuah shlema for all those injured. You've taken the Torah that you've been given by your parents, by your teachers, and you've started to receive it and make it your own. You've started to internalize the values and the lessons of emunah, of belief in Hashem, of midot, proper character, and dedication to Torah and to mitzvot. Talmidim Karim, this is your identity. These are the values that will guide you throughout your entire lives to stay true to Hashem, the Jewish people, and really yourselves. And especially at this time in history, this is more important than ever. My bracha to you on behalf of all your teachers and the entire staff is that you always remember who you are and remain guided by these values as you make a positive impact and take your place as the Jewish leaders in the world. Mazal tov. Gives me great joy to ask you to bring up Zachary Kupiecki, who will share a Dvar Torah on behalf of his classmates.
Toda rabba, Rabbi Linzer. Mazel tov l'kita tavshin pei dalet. Toda l'chol mishbacha ve'chavarim sh'agiu l'chagogot itanu ha'erev. Ani rotze lakir toda l'chol mishazar lanu l'makom bo anu nimsayim hayom. Rabbi Linzer, Rav Natan, Mr. Shandeloff, Rabbi Liebtag, Mrs. Koplow, Mrs. Lakin, and Ms. Garden. Azartem letzev kol echad meitanu liyo misha nachnu hayom. A special shout out to Mrs. Wortman and Mrs. Sokol for your support and help throughout our years at Hillel Torah. Rabbi Liebtag, for your mentorship and guidance. Thank you so much to our parents who've helped us move our tassels from the right to the left. We appreciate your love and dedication. You've been our personal cheering squads, and we have huge hakara atov. Lastly, thank you to Hashem for making all of this possible. This year, our theme at Hillel Torah was Hineni, Ani Po, I am here. Hineni is a message of hope and strength spoken by leaders throughout the Torah. The call to be present is one that has inspired and motivated. In his iconic message to the American people, President Theodore Roosevelt said, "The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly. The message to us is clear. It is what we do that matters." This year, Hillel Torah brought three heroes from the Torah to the forefront, Avraham, Yaakov, and Moshe, who all said Hineni. I would like to suggest that our journey at Hillel Torah can parallel them. Avraham's midot shaped our skills in the little school, while Yaakov's strength helped us navigate the big school. Moshe's resilience has been our inspiration for all of middle school, especially this year. Avram taught us our foundational skills. While recovering from his Brit Milah, he ran out of his tent to welcome three wandering men into his home. Similarly, he exemplified kindness and selflessness when he davened for stone. While at Little Hillel Torah, we embodied these lessons. From calling a friend to wish them a refuah shlema, to learning more Krupnik's Eichachayil, to the excitement of being Shabbos Ima and Abba, from inviting mystery readers and Rabbi Smiley to Rabbi Linzer's Friday visits, we were learning Hachnas Adorchim, Gimlut Chasadim, and the spirit of Shabbos. This was the essence of Avraham. As we moved on to the big school, we really became part of the Hillel Torah family. Throughout Yaakov's life, he continued to grow, from leaving his home to being the father of the 12 Shvatim and fighting the angel of Esav. Yaakov's path gave him the fundamentals necessary to become Av B'nai Israel. Throughout our primary grades, we too were given the core tools to be set up for success. We received our Siddur and Chumash, Rav Shimon taught us Rashi, and we were Mor Amina's first class to have a Siyum with Sefer Breishit. We learned to read and write, and teachers like Mrs. Cohen and Ms. Weinstein pushed us to the best of our abilities through the Chicago and state fairs. We started middle school during COVID, arguably our hardest challenge, and we had to learn to adapt like Moshe did throughout his life, demonstrating flexibility, resilience, and leadership. Moshe went from being the prince of Egypt to a stranger in Midian. Moshe adjusted, started a new life, and remained ready to serve. When Moshe said Hineni at the burning bush, it meant that no matter what obstacles came to him, he was flexible and he dealt with them. Like Moshe, we were also leaders as eighth graders. Whether it was our Slichot Kumzitz, yearbook, basketball, Maccabiah, or our recent DC trip, we showed what we are capable of as a unit. Names Not Numbers and the Yom HaAtzmaut Tekes inspired us as a grade to flex our maturity muscles and our leadership skills. October 7th reminded us of our roles and responsibilities within Hillel Torah and the Jewish community. Hineni is the perfect message to the graduating class as we are moving on to new challenges and new opportunities. Hillel Torah has shaped us into the people that we are today. No matter where our respective journeys take us, I know we will look back fondly at these incredible and fun years. When Hillel Torah and the Jewish community at large call on us, we are ready to say, Hineni ani po.
Yasher koach, Zachary, for those beautiful remarks. And now it gives me great joy to invite you to call your attention to Michal Levy, who will offer Divrei Chizuk on behalf of her classmates.
Hillel Omer Al Tifrash Min Hatzibor. In Pirkei Avot, Hillel stated, do not separate yourself from the community. Rabbi Avraham Yitzchak Cook stated, the soul of the individual is drawn from the community, the community bestowing a soul upon the individual. Many great scholars saw the importance of a community. So too does Hillel Torah see the importance of a community. The school has created an amazing community. When I look back on my years here at Hillel Torah, the word that constantly comes to mind is community. This is because everyone at the school, no matter what, is always united and standing together. I learned a valuable lesson at Hillel Torah that when united, nothing can stop us. Even the toughest times won't break us. Through the good and the bad, the Hillel Torah community stands strong. As we move forward into our high school careers, wherever that may be, we'll join many new communities. In these communities, we'll learn Gemara, Chumash, English, social studies, and much, much more. We may experience pain and loss, while at the same time feel excitement and joy. We'll meet new people and gain many connections. And through it all, we'll always look back on our amazing experiences in the Hillel Torah community that has taught us everything we need to know to move forward with our lives. Whether we become teachers, rabbis, lawyers, doctors, and more, we'll have reached those milestones because of this amazing foundation and community we had at Hillel Torah. On the wall of the Diaspora Museum in Tel Aviv, there's a quote from an anonymous Holocaust survivor which asserts, remember the past, live the present, trust the future. During the Holocaust, the Jews reflected on the past and realized that as a nation, we have overcome so much, so we are able to overcome this. They did this while they still lived in their extremely difficult present. The Jews in the Holocaust did their best to survive and help others in their communities not only survive, but thrive. Moreover, they continue to imagine a future and fight for it. They are the reason we have Israel and much more now. These people are just another example of why community is so important. Without it, many Jews in the Holocaust would not have survived, and many of us would not be here today. We can learn from them the important lesson that without a community, we as the Jewish people are nothing. Therefore, we must stay connected and intertwined within our Jewish communities. Just like the Jews of the past who helped those in their communities, we must ensure that we help our communities of the present and of the future develop. Hatikva sheli overeinu hi shenatzliach benamshich la'azor lekilot shelanu. My hope for us is that we succeed and continue to help out our community.
Thank you, Michal. That definitely resonates with all of us. In just a moment, we'll have an opportunity to see a special video featuring our graduates and some amazing footage looking back at their years at Hillel Torah. Before we do, though, I'd like to ask Tziona Maurer and Avi Friedman to come up for a special announcement.
Okay. At this point in the program, we would like to take a moment to acknowledge the people with us tonight who helped get us here. We know we could not have done it alone.
We want to thank you, the members of our families who are here to celebrate this day with us. You supported us, cheered us on, celebrated our accomplishments, and were there with us on the hard days.
Thank you for making our lunches, helping us with our homework, making playdates, driving carpools, and everything in between.
As a class, we are excited to come to you now with a token of our appreciation.
The class of 2024 is an amazing group of kids with a lot of personality, a lot of creativity, a lot of spunk, and a lot of ruach. Over their years at Hillel Torah, this class has really experienced a lot. They had an amazing foundation. We're so proud of them, and we know we're going to see great things ahead from this group of young men and women.
In pre-nursery, Little Torah, it was really cool coming here and then seeing all the big kids in one and being like, oh my God, like I can't wait to be an eighth grader. I really looked up to them. So it's just really cool to finally be an eighth grader.
Pre-nursery and nursery, when you would walk in to school, there was like always this excitement on Friday. One of the best parts for me was Friday reader, and it was like always so exciting to see who they were at the end and give them a big hug. And like it's so fun to like see your mom like read to all your class.
In preschool, we went to this matzah factory, and me and my brother got to make matzah for Pesach, and my dad got to come, so it was like very special that we got to go on a trip with my dad.
In kindergarten, when we sang the Hot Tikvah, when we said Eretz Zion, me and my friends would always look at each other and just giggle because we were like, oh, Sion, me and Sion, I thought it was my name. So now when we like say Hatikva, me and my friends still laugh about it sometimes.
In first grade, we went to the aquarium and I had this little smartwatch little thing that I was like, oh, cool fish. And I just took like 1 million pictures of each fish. And like a year later, I came back to it and I was like, man, I took like 1,000 pictures at the aquarium in first grade.
In the sitter play, we were just learning how to daven. We barely even knew what Ashrei was or Matovu. And now as an eighth grader, I like know basically all of davening, and I'm able to sort of look back on my first sitter and say like, wow, how did I only know this much? Now I know all of this.
We do the Chicago Fair in third grade. Every student gets a landmark in Chicago, which they research, and we made posters about it. And then we also like made a replica out of our landmark.
My project was the Civic Opera House, and we saw when we were on the river, we actually saw it, and it was a really cool experience to see. Being out of school with my friends was like pretty fun.
I actually played with the fourth grade with Marmina, and we got to recreate what it was like to be Rashi and act as a commentary in real life situations, and I thought that was really cool.
In school, you have teachers, but in Gemar, you have something called a Rebbe. And one thing that I felt that is really good for me is that asking questions straight to Rebbe, it just feels comfortable. All rabbis, they're all way different, but they all have one thing in common, and that's creating new openings for other peoples that are in need.
I like Rabbi Liebtag's class and him as a teacher because he really impacted me in my Jewish life. I started going to shul more, and he makes his class really fun.
Back in sixth grade, when I was in Mishnah class, Rabbi Freeman pulled me out of class and told me that I did a great job on my test. For Rabbi Freeman, it was a small thing, but for me, it was a big thing because it made me feel like really comfortable in this atmosphere of Hillel Torah and just really welcomed.
One of the lessons we learned at Hillel Torah is Kavod HaTorah, to show appreciation of the Jewish people and Hashem. I've seen my teachers and my Rebbeim show respect and have Kavod HaTorah to students, and inspired me to have and show Kavod HaTorah.
During lunch and learn, you bring your lunch into a row and you get a Dvar Torah from a rabbi. Lunch and learn is a great opportunity for us to come together, and there's prizes and it's fun.
Chesed is a big part of Hillel Torah, so we went to Maot Kli Team, which provides food for thousands of poor people, and we made boxes for them to pack into the food into the boxes. I felt good about it because I'm able to help the community out.
One of the extracurricular activities we had was flag football, and it was really fun, especially since we won the championship game. It was a lot of fun to play with the different grades and teach them part of the game.
Chidon is this group where we learn like 70 parakim a year of Tanakh, Torah, Nevi'im, and Ketuvim. Both years I made to New York, where we do this final regional. It's really fun. And then there's this pizza restaurant right next door to the building, which is really good.
Springfield was an amazing trip. You got to hang out with friends, go on long bus rides and talk with them, see lots of cool places. My favorite memory was probably the bus ride back, because there was like a lot of jokes and everyone was laughing and it was just a great time.
Color Wear is awesome because the passion we show in what we do really brings out the emotion with our friends, and how we express it at the end is really fun because we all have a great time with the plays, the art, and it's just a really fun experience.
When we went to Camp Nagila in sixth grade, we did a lot of teamwork and like friendship activities with the kids in our grade. We did like a hula hoop game. Before we went on the bus, we did like a big water fight with like all the teachers and all the kids who went to Camp Nagila, and that was a lot of fun.
Last year in seventh grade, we led field day, and it was a really cool experience because every single person had either one or two partners, and we all got a chance to lead and make games and just give all the little kids a really fun day.
The Berm Carnival was super fun. We all got to make our own games and learn what it's like being in charge of a carnival and helping younger kids. We learned how to like encourage people, and overall I've had a good experience.
This is my second year being an eighth grade girls advisor, and I love it. I love the connections that I have with the girls. I'm gonna miss these girls so much, and I hope that our connection still remains for the rest of their lives.
Something really special about this group to me is how they had these cute little personalities in first and third grade that have grown into these mature, adult-like people that are so awesome to work with.
I feel very confident that this particular group of students is well prepared for the rigor of high school and college with all the writing that they've shown me that they're capable of doing in middle school.
My wish to the class of 2024 is to always keep getting the most out of every experience that you have. Keep interacting with the world around you. You bring so much light and laughter to every experience and every person that you meet. You certainly have left your mark here at Hillel Torah, and we have learned a lot and will miss you a lot.
I love you guys, and it's been a pleasure to be with you these past couple years and to learn with you and learn from you. And my bracha to you all is that you take all that you're learning that you've done here in Hillel Torah, that you take it and become adults who love to daven and love to learn Torah and love to serve Hashem in high school and beyond.
אז המסר שלי אליכם, תעשו את הכי טוב שלכם ותשמרו על הזהות היהודית שלכם. עם ישראל חי, אנחנו ביחד, אם בארץ ואם בחול. אוהב אתכם. A little bit of history I've been through. Ask me where I'm from and I will tell you. I'm a Jew and every Jew's a proud Jew.
I've found connections to Israel through school and multiple places, through our shluchim, our teachers who came from Israel, and our classmates who are from Israel, and classes about Israel. We learn a lot about Israel from people and places.
October 7th was a terrible day. The Shabbos table was a table where there were candles and all the hostages and chairs for all the hostages. And it was really sad to see how many hostages there were. and what had happened to them and where they were, like, kidnapped. The Shabbos table deepened my connection to Hashem because I knew that I could trust Hashem even though it was so terrible.
In our 8th grade Gemara this year, we had a Chabur project when there was each group had to present something, like, on Pesach. So I had Lechem Oni, and preparing my own, like, Chabura, it was a good learning experience. It was much easier than I thought, and we had a good Chabura.
The 8th grade Shabbaton was great. We sang, we ate food, we had fun. It was just a great time. We had a chance to take over the main minyan at Or Torah. We got to lane, we got to daven, and it was really a great opportunity.
Right before the 8th grade Shabbaton, during, like, Gemara class, we went and we all talked, we're going to start, like, a kumzitz, we're going to go crazy and stuff. So we went to the hallway and we started singing it. And we got everyone involved, so it made everyone feel good before a great Shabbos and a great opportunity as a group.
I love reading. And if I really think about it, my love of reading actually came from school. I know that later in life, my reading and writing skills will be really useful, and I know that that foundation was set by Hillel Torah.
When I move on from Hillel Torah, I will look back on my years here positively because I learned a lot, I had great teachers, and I had fun time being at school.
I would really like to say thank you to every teacher, admin, support staff, everyone at Hillel Torah, all of the students, all of the older grades and the younger grades, really setting us up for success with whatever we do in the future.
It gives me great pleasure to present to you the graduating class of 2024 Tufshin Pei Dalet. Zachary Kupietsky.
Kobe Harris.
Benjamin Friedman.
Jonah Kruel.
Caleb Speicher.
Jordan Rich.
Menachem Steinberg.
Emmett Gelman.
Yishai Nankin.
Ari Shaevitz.
Eli Komarov.
Kobe Gordon.
Woo! All right. Tali Beitner.
Eliana Stolberg.
Adi Greika.
Michal Levy.
Yeah.
Miriam Linzer.
Aww.
Emily Itzhaki.
Sophie Levin.
Emily Adler.
Tiona Maurer. Eitan Spolter.
Yair Dreitzer.
Gabriel Rich.
Abby Friedman.
Lior Kirshner.
Zeke Spiegel.
Yeah! Elior Ginsburg.
Sammy Beitner.
Aaron Gelb.
Mazal Tov, class of 2024. You may now move your tassels from the right to the left. Along with their diplomas, each graduate also, as you saw, received a beautiful Tanakh endowed by the Haynes family, which will help them keep the Torah at the forefront of their minds and their hearts as they move on to high school. This is the part of our graduation where we typically acknowledge those families, those students that are the last in their families to graduate Hillel Torah. Tonight, I'd like to, somewhat uncharacteristically, take a moment of personal privilege as our family name will be on the list as well. For the past 15 years, I've not only had the privilege of serving as the principal here, but also as a Hillel Torah parent. When Devorah and I came out to check out the school and the community 15 years ago, it wasn't only that we felt that Hillel Torah would be a great fit for me professionally, but we felt confident that this was the right school and the right community for our children. I'd like to take a moment tonight on behalf of our family and all the families who are going to be on this list, and really all the families represented in the room tonight, to extend a tremendous and heartfelt Hakarat HaTov, gratitude and appreciation to the countless, incredible, amazing, warm, talented, and caring Morot, teachers, Rebbeim, office staff, maintenance crew, security, administration, PTA leaders, board members, every member of our community who has helped make Hillel Torah the incredible place it has been, who have given our children, our personal children, and all of the children here, the most incredible foundation in Limudei Kodesh, Limudei Chol, and most importantly, as well-adjusted, caring human beings and proud Jews. We can never thank you enough. And now, we're going to announce the children who are the last in their families to be graduating from Hillel Torah tonight, Avi Friedman, Emily Yitzchaki, Zachary Kupietsky, Michal Levy, Miriam Linzer, Gabriel Rich, Jordan Rich, and Zeke Spiegel. great to see so many alumni here tonight. You'll always be part of the Hillel Torah family, and we hope you'll stay in touch and involved as alumni as well. There's another special person who has been a key part, and you saw in the video almost every picture of Hillel Torah, who will be moving on at the end of this school year. I want to take a moment to recognize and give a tremendous thank you to Rabbi Aaron Liebtag. For all you have done for the students of Hillel Torah as a beloved Rebbe, advisor, trusted friend, guiding and inspiring countless students over many years, and colleagues as well as students with your warmth, your wisdom, and laughter. We wish you much hatzlacha as you begin your new journey, and we're very proud of you for this as the principal of the Fastman Yeshiva High School, not too far away, and we know you'll always remain part of the Hillel Torah family. Now please give your attention to Ari Shaivitz, who will lead us in the closing Tehillim on behalf of his classmates.
Rabbis, teachers, family, and friends, this has been an incredibly difficult year in Jewish history. Since October 7th, Jews in Israel have suffered a series of terrible losses. Here in the U.S., anti-Semitism is at the worst it's been in most of our lifetimes. But still, we stand here today, celebrating a joyous occasion. How can we balance these conflicting emotions? How can we feel connected to our brothers and sisters in Israel while joyfully marking our own milestone here in Galut? Tehillim Kuf Chaf Bet offers an inspirational answer. Shir Hama'alot, LeDavid Samachti BeOmri Li Beit Hashem Nelech. David rejoiced when it was said to him they would go to the Beit Hashem, the house of God. What does Beit Hashem refer to here? At first glance, it's fairly simple. It's the Beit HaMikdash. But this can't be the whole story, as the Beit HaMikdash didn't yet exist during David's lifetime. Perhaps in a metaphorical sense, a Beit Hashem could be any building in which we connect to Hashem and His Torah, a Mikdash Me'at. Kol makom she'anu mitchabrim la'Hashem hu Beit Hashem, kol makom she'osim po mitzvot, shelomdim bo Torah u'mitpalalim hu nachshav Beit Hashem. In Hillel Torah, through the constant upkeep of our Jewish tradition, through learning tefillah and mitzvot, we have created our very own mikdash me'at. The metaphor extends to the next pasuk. Omdot hayu raglenu b'sha'araich Yerushalayim. Our feet stand within your gates, Jerusalem. Not only has Hillel Torah served as our Beit Hashem, it has also anchored us in the land of Israel. The shlichim and benot shirut who bring the spirit of Israel with them, the celebrations and programs for Yom HaTzmaut, even things as small as the Israeli music played a drop-off every morning, Hillel Torah has made us feel every day as if our feet are planted in the ground in Yerushalayim. Yerushalayim habnuya ke'ir shechubra la yachtav. Jerusalem is built as a compact city, tightly knit, and I cannot think of a better way to describe Hillel Torah as well. The firm bonds in our community here at Hillel Torah are unbreakable, and though we are leaving the school, the community will always be a part of us. Sha'alu Shalom Yerushalayim. Pray for the peace and well-being of Jerusalem. Today we find ourselves praying for peace in Israel and Yerushalayim more than ever. And when we daven for peace in Israel, we are not alone. Laman achai v'rei'ai adabrana shalom bach. For the sake of my brothers and my fellows, I pray for your well-being. The whole community of Hillel Torah davens with and for each other. The lifelong friendships and bonds formed in Hillel Torah and our connection to Am Yisrael and Eretz Yisrael will never weaken or break. Laman Beit Hashem Elokeinu Avaksha Tov Lach. For the sake of the house of Hashem our God, I will seek your good. For so many of us students, Hillel Torah was the first place we felt a genuine sense of community, a place where we established our first friendships and discovered our passions. Some of us started here as 3 to 4 year olds. Some of us are still 3 to 4 year olds. I'm joking. We have watched each other learn, mature, and develop into the people we are today. It hasn't been an easy year for the Jewish people. but we can celebrate knowing that the programs, traditions, and community that Hillel Torah has provided us ensure our pride in our identity and our firm belief in who we are as individuals and as a people. No matter what, I am proud to be a Jew, and I am proud to have spent 11 years of my life at Hillel Torah. I want to thank you all for attending our graduation ceremony tonight. Thank you so much to all the teachers and staff at Hillel Torah who have done so much to help us grow, whether holding the door open for us in the morning, or teaching us to read Rashi, or solve an equation, or write a proper essay. We are so grateful to each and every one of you. To our families who have invested in our religious and secular education and who have given us the gift of Hillel Torah, thank you. May we all merit to celebrate our next big milestone in Yerushalayim with our Achim Vereim during the coming of Mashiach. B'shana haba b'Yerushalayim habanuya. Mazel tov to the class of 2024.
Beautiful message, Ari. Thank you. Thank you to Talia Zidzuk, the talented pianist who's helping us tonight, who is actually Hillel Torah class of 96. Thank you, Talia. Thank you to Anita Gelbar, to Sam Toljanik, to Tali Garden, Dov Shandalov, Miriam Kapilov, Rav Natan Brownstein, Sarah Lakin, Rabbi Liebtag, and Pavel Redzina for making tonight's graduation run so smoothly. And on time. Immediately following the recessional, all guests are invited to a reception across the way in the auditorium in honor of the graduates. Thank you to Edie Kupiecki and Devorah Linzer for organizing the decor and the reception. At approximately 8:20, we will have a minyan from Mariv in room 16 back at the school. Everyone's invited and encouraged to help make the minyan, including our graduates. As we celebrate here tonight, our hearts, as we've heard from all our students, our hearts are in Israel. We now ask you, as we conclude the ceremony, to please rise, give your attention to Yishai Nankin, who will recite a Misha Beirach for Medinat Yisrael, our soldiers, and the safe return of our precious hostages, after which we will invite everyone to join together in HaTikvah.
Misha Beirach, Avotenu, Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov, Yosef, Moshe, Aaron, David, Shlomo, Huyuverech, Vyabepe, Et Nifkei, Polot, Haiba, Sheiru, Bechag, Simchat, Torah, Uvaikvotav, Vishlach, Lahem, Behera, Refuash, Lemam, Inashemaim, Betoch, Shar, Chole, Israel, Vyverech, Vishmor, Vinsor, Et Nadarim, Vashvayim, Betoch, Shar, Achenu, Beit Israel, and Atunim, Batzara, Vishivya, Yoshivay Merer, the Chik, Mishpachotahem, Bereim, Bushlamim, Beguf, Uvenefesh, Vivarech, Vechazek, Echt, Chile, Tzvagan, Israel, Vigochot, Abitachon, Veshmirim, Yazilin, Mikol, Saravitsuka, Van Chilim, Elohenu, Yeshua, Vater, Nitzuchon, Tatarem, Vatata, Shalom, Baarts, Visimchat, Olam, Bachadut, Yoshveha, Shanemar, Kilo, Yotosh, Adonai, Amol, Venachalotol, Veloyozov, Vechin, Yhiratsom, Vedamar, Amen.
Amen. Please be seated for the recessional. Oh, great job, guys. Done. Great job. You're done. You're done. You're done. This is it.